How much of having all of that freedom to explore, to create, have the expression of this world and not be tied to a biopic, how much freedom did that allow you to just sort of go on a bit of a mind bender?
It's not a biopic, but the approach was that the Freud we're telling could be actually the real Freud. So we tried to be very close to his biography about the time where he was this young man. So he was like around 30. He was working as a doctor in a hospital. He tried to find his own practice. He was in love with his endless fiancée, Marta Bernay. And then around him, we created this genre world of the cop, the war hero, Kiss, the murderers, and the weird Hungarians with their rituals. And we mixed them all together.
Also, the openness of the cocaine drug taking that helps take us to places that the story really needs to propel to. Freud really believes in the cocaine making him better, like a better man. But the cocaine side, biographically, was that correct about Freud?
Yes, yes, we researched that. That was actually what he did back then. So he really was also into measuring it, the doses of how much he should take. And he had an own journal where he took notes about it. Of course, that was his legitimation for taking a lot of it. But what was really interesting for us at the beginning, when we started with the series, we saw this portray of the old Freud, who looks sinister and very strict into the camera with the cigar in the hand, and a respectable person, one of the most known intellectuals in our timeline, in our history. And it was a very important process to throw him from this, to create a human being with flaws, with mistakes, with irritations, with weaknesses, with restlessnesses, with addiction, with a brilliant mind, with anger. Because the old Freud was really about creating his own biography. So that was our aim, to understand who was the young Freud.
How exciting from an Austrian filmmaker is it to have this whole globalization through Netflix for people right across the globe to watch what you've done with Freud?
The thing with pressure that the whole world is possible, this is an abstract feeling. You can't actually understand that the whole world is seeing your stuff, even when they telling you that 60 million people saw your show. It sounds insane, but you actually can't create a feeling for it. You know, when I start studying film and making film, I had no idea about Netflix. And when I become a filmmaker, I start doing my first films for the cinema. And suddenly I was on a party in Toronto, on a Netflix party in 2013 with my second feature, Blood Glacier. And I didn't know what Netflix was in 2013. And imagine 5 years later, everything is about Netflix. And yeah, Netflix is huge. It changes the whole industry because it gives so many young people the chances to show their talent. They're searching for unique, crazy ideas. They let me do what I wanted to do. And Netflix trusted my vision. That's huge. That's something I feel very privileged for.